So what's going to happen is you're going to start running. You're going to get there before it beeps. If you don't get there the second time, that's two lives. Third time, you're out.
You have to be an athlete, first and foremost. You have to enjoy sport. You have to enjoy the physicality of hard work.
My name is Debbie Butts. I am head of the recruitment here, and I am also the nursing sister here at the Jockey Academy. I need you to understand that just because you come today does not mean you're in. You're very far from in.
Our recruitment process has really changed a lot. I mean, when I started here, we would get the doctors to fill out a medical form. You would come with your left wrist x-ray, an eye test, and that was it. Now, obviously we would measure you and we would see how tall you are, and they would measure your knee height, and someone would shake your hand and see how strong you are. That's all good, but you know, some of it can be a little bit subjective. You need it to be objective.
What made you want to be a jockey?
I'm willing and able.
You're willing and able?
Yes, I would like.
Do you like horses?
Yes, I love animals actually.
We've made it a process now, because not only do we measure your weight when you come in here, we actually look at your body fat. Body fat is a very important part of what we do here, and we manage that body fat very tightly. Now, it's not fat, as we know fat, it's your body fat is all over you. It's around in your brain, it's around your heart, it's around your lungs. So when your body fat is very low, all sorts of things start to happen. So your immunity goes down, your healing goes down, your concentration is affected, your mood is affected. It has a terrible knock-on effect for athletes with very low body fat. So when we have kids who have low body fat, we're more likely to see someone fall and have a bad fracture, because it influences your bone health as well. And then what happens is they have a very slow, long process of healing. So we don't want that, okay? So you've got to have a good body fat, which means you've got to have a healthy weight, and then that has to correlate with your heart. So we need to look at all those things. We also measure your fitness coming in. So that's not something that people are really prepared for, but it is something to bear in mind, because if you, like I said, this is an athletic career, you can't come in not being able to do push-ups, not being able to run.
The beep test is very important for fitness-wise. When they do that initial beep test, it gives us some sort of idea of the fitness that we're working with going forward. Gym is very important for their strength and their balance and everything like that. So everything we do plays a part in their riding.
Unfortunately for the kids that are not athletic enough, I think that's the thing that can trip people up. They can think that they're very sporty, and they just don't have the level of physicality that we require. It is very physical. The other thing I think is the mental grit that is required for doing professional sport. Maybe not necessarily just us. I mean, here you've thrown in the horse as well, so you have to get over that fear. Some people, they just never get over that fear. And it's something that they're able to control in the beginning, but as the pressure is put on, so now you're up a track, and now you're working with babies, and now you're going through the pens, and now you're about to start racing, or you're in the race, and if you aren't able to get over that fear, it doesn't really work for you. Interpersonal skills is a real big one. You are your own business. If you can't manage yourself amongst adults and in sometimes quite a a pressurized environment around people who want a lot from you, and your interpersonal skills are poor and they keep letting you down, again, you don't really tend to make it. I mean, you know, the things like weight and height and all that sort of thing we can look at, and that's very measurable. These things are not measurable things because they're not tangible. These are the soft skills, and very often it can make or break a person.